Hello and welcome to your Simplified Coin Review. So before we go any further, I want to let you guys know about our contest. I'll put the details behind me. Also, if you missed our last video, we have renamed the channel. Instead of the BitBoy and HODL channel, we're now called the BitBoy Crypto channel. So you can watch our last video to understand why we did that. So let's jump in. So what we're going to be looking at today is we're going to be looking at NEP5 tokens. Now, before we go further, it's also important I point out this is a very brief overview. There's a lot of projects, and I want to go over each one of them. We're only going to be able to spend maybe 30 seconds or a minute on each one, so this is not an exhaustive list. At the end of the video, I'll tell you guys which one of these are my favorites, so you know you might want to stay tuned for that. But what is a NEP5 token? So a NEP5 token, NEP5 stands for NEO Enhancement Proposal. So it's just like an ERC20 to Ethereum. So these are tokens that are built on the NEO platform and on their open source project. People call it the Ethereum of China. So here I'm on CoinMarketCap, and as you guys can see, I have separated out tokens by platform. So if you look right here, you can see where you can do that. You can go to tokens only and go to full list. And then after that pops up, you can hit platform. And now it's going to list each platform that makes cryptocurrency. So watch how many Ethereum is. Of course, EOS, Tron, and VeChain are the top Ethereum projects. And then, man, there's so many of these on Ethereum. There are ERC20 tokens galore. People are talking about Ethereum can fail. With this many projects on it, it's really hard for me to see Ethereum ever failing, honestly. So then we keep going down, and we get down near the bottom of the list, and that's when NEO pops up. So as you can see, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 projects that are being built right now on NEO, known as NEP5 tokens. So the first one we'll look at is Ontology. There is 1 billion in total supply. Right now, there's only 122 in circulating supply. Market cap around 800 million. And we're going to be going into these in descending order. So Ontology is the one with the most market cap. And then the last one we look at will have the least. So as I mentioned, it is a NEP5 token. Ontology, you can kind of think of it as the jelly to NEO's peanut butter, if you will. They also have recently signed an MOU, a Memorandum of Understanding, with NEO. But a lot of people think that might lead to an official, actual partnership, which is hard for me to understand why that's necessary, as I mentioned in a different video, because already NEO and Ontology share Da Hongfei, the founder of NEO, the CEO of Onchain, which is the company that produced Ontology. So Ontology is a new high-performance blockchain project and distributed trust collaboration platform. So basically, it's smart contracts built on trust. And you can watch our review video on Ontology for more information on it. It's in our CoinReview playlist. It's one of the first ones that we actually did to understand exactly what it does. Like I said in this video, we're not going to be able to go that far in depth with each of these projects. So Gas is the next one. Market cap of 185 million, so considerably smaller than Ontology. Circulating supply is 10 million. Max supply is 100 million. So there's exactly the same amount of tokens for Gas as there is for NEO. So NEO's max supply is also 100 million. So Gas, see, if you click on website for Gas, it just takes you to the NEO website. So Gas is like the fuel for the NEO platform. And one thing I've noticed about Gas and NEO is they tend to move together. So if NEO moves up, Gas moves up a pretty proportionate price. If NEO goes down, Gas goes down with it. Of course, everything's dependent on Bitcoin right now. But if we were to separate Bitcoin out, it seems like these two are really tethered at the hip. And so for that reason, of course, what I'm about to tell you is not financial advice. I would say that if you're looking for a NEP5 token to invest in, Gas would probably not be the one to do it because it's almost redundant. Like if you want to invest in NEO, just invest more in NEO. There's no reason in my mind, and maybe you'll tell me I'm wrong, but there's no reason in my mind to really have both of them. So Deep Brain Chain is next. It's coming in at 113 on CoinMarketCap, a cap of $113 million, max supply of 10 billion Deep Brain Chain tokens, or DBCs as they call them. So Deep Brain Chain is trying to combine AI computing with blockchain. Previous to Matrix AI's rise, Deep Brain Chain was all people were talking about in regards to AI. But actually, over the last couple months, a few more competitors have popped up. So what is it? So using blockchain technology, we've developed a decentralized, low-cost, and privacy-protecting AI computing platform with a full range of related products and services. DeepBrainChain is a decentralized neural network. Countless nodes across the world will supply computational power to AI companies and receive DBC as rewards. Okay, so this is basically what it's trying to do. So very similar to Golem and how it lets people borrow computing power, this is trying to do the same thing, except specifically with AI. So if you're running a AI program on your computer, but you don't have enough power to do it, you can borrow the power through this project. So next, we will look at the key. It is coming in at 170 on CoinMarketCap. It has a total supply of 9 billion, the key tokens, 69 million in market cap. So the key is identity verification. And recently, Civic is another project that is doing something similar. I don't believe they're doing it as well as the key, but Civic had a beer vending machine at Consensus, and people had to verify their identity through the blockchain to be able to purchase the alcohol, because if they're under 21, obviously, they could not purchase it. So I'm not sure exactly how it worked, because I wasn't there, probably with your license. Maybe they would scan it. I think that's probably the only way that it would work, but the key is trying to do that as well. It's an identity verification tool. So I think this is absolutely huge to be able to keep, like, let's say kids that are under 18 off of sites they shouldn't be on, or online gambling or pornography or whatever it may be. I think verifying identity in the future is going to be really huge. You know, you got to be careful, like, if you have kids, what they look like on their phones. I'm not sure if somehow that'll be identity verification will be able to be placed on the blockchain with phones, so that a phone knows the age of the person who has it. So that would be kind of cool to maybe limit features or whatever. It's like parental control on steroids. Next, we have Apex coming in at 187, currently at 58 million in market cap, total supply 676 million CPX. So Apex, what they're really trying to focus on is getting enterprises or businesses to work very well and to know their customers. And of course, if they know their customers better, then they will be able to understand how to sell them products better, how to supply them better, and how to serve their needs better. So that is what Apex is doing. So going forward with these, we're gonna go through them pretty quick just for the sake of time. Redpulse coming in at 204, market cap 47 million, total supply 1.358 million RPX. So Redpulse is a very China-specific project. So it says Redpulse is a market intelligence platform covering China's financial and capital markets. So Redpulse will introduce a token RPX that will power a brand new content production, distribution, and consumption platform focused initially on China's capital markets. So AlphaCat, right now coming in a shade over a penny, 158 Satoshis. Total supply is 6.25 billion ACAT tokens. The market cap is at 32 million, and it is ranked 261 on CoinMarketCap. And look at that chart. Man, the volume on this thing has shot through the roof recently. While everything else is falling, it is climbing. So it could be something that you might consider getting into. Not financial advice, of course. So what is AlphaCat? So AlphaCat uses trading algorithms to basically let investors know when the optimal times to buy things are. So it's a robo-advisor. It's based on algorithms, AI, big data. And I know some people who actually know a little bit about this project and say it's pretty good. So I think it could be one to watch. Trinity Network Credit coming in ranked 264, so not far behind AlphaCat. Market cap is at 32 million. Total supply is 1 billion TNC tokens. And as you can see, it launched right after the crash, or it looks like kind of in the midst of the crash almost. So what is Trinity Network? Trinity is a universal off-chain scaling solution which aims to achieve real-time payments, low transaction fees, scalability, and privacy protection for main chain assets. Let's look at Zeepin. So Zeepin is coming in at 267, also very close. It's at 31, almost $32 million in market cap. $1 billion is the total supply. So basically, Zeepin, you can think of it almost like Poet. So it says Zeepin is the world's first customized platform that provides more protection, more recognition, more connection, and more support for everyone in the creative industries. So if you're a content creator, then this might be a project you want to invest in, as it is basically trying to have content protection on the blockchain. So it's a really cool idea. I really like it. There's nothing worse than having your content stolen. and other people being able to monetize it, and you can't. So next is Qlink. Qlink has actually recently gone through a rebrand. It is now known as QLC Chain, but it still does come up as Qlink on CoinMarketCap. I don't know if they have to change that or what's involved there. It's coming at 291, market cap 27.8 million. 600 million is the total supply, so a little lower than most. Most are coming in at a billion in total supply. So it's 11.5 cents approximately. So let's check out the website. Here's the QLC chain website. So it's the public chain for decentralized network as a service where everyone can operate and benefit from network services. As you can see here, the image has someone on a phone. So basically the whole premise of this project is that there are a lot of problems within mobile networks, and they want to try to solve them. So that's the decentralized network as a service. Next, we have Aphelion. So it's coming in at 413, so considerably down from the last ones we looked at. Market cap at 14 million. Total supply is 70 million. So if you're looking for some gems that are very low in market cap, we're starting to get in that area. One thing I noticed out of a lot of these much smaller Net5 tokens is most of them involve decentralized exchanges. So it's coming in at 38 cents. Market cap 14 million. Total supply 70 million AFE tokens, if you will. So a revolutionary peer-to-peer trading platform. So it's a crypto decentralized exchange, and they actually haven't launched the exchange yet. As you can see up here, it says it's coming soon. So effect.ai, EFX is the symbol, another AI project on the Neo platform. So it's coming in rank 551. It's 7 million in market cap, so it's very low, 650 million EFX tokens. As you can see, it's been on a very steady fall, but of course, just going along with the Bitcoin fall. So here is their website. So Decentralized Mechanical Turk. Turn your data into an AI-powered asset. So it's doing something a lot different than Deep Brain Chain, but still in the AI space. AI and blockchain just feel like a very natural fit for each other. So EffectForce is an on-demand human intelligent workforce that scales to any size, allowing you to outsource any number of recurring tasks. This frees you from routine and paves the way for a more efficient application of your company's resources. So I've talked a lot on my channel about how I have some other businesses and I've done other things in the past. And one thing I did involved getting a lot of people from Upwork to help me with some projects. And what I found is the thing about using Upwork is people are very cheap there, especially if you use people from other countries and over in the eastern side of the world. The problem is you end up explaining to them so much what they have to do that it almost becomes a job just to explain to them what they have to do. So if you were able to have a workforce on AI where you could plug in certain parameters and the bots would automatically know how to perform those tasks, I think that would be really cool. So next we have Switch.io coming in at $13.96, unknown market cap, similar to Pundi X, that they're currently doing a swap. So because of that, they're coming in extremely low when actually once the swap is over, it'll probably shoot back up. I'm not sure exactly where to. Total supply is 1 billion. So Switch.io is another decentralized exchange. So it's the world's first multi-chain decentralized exchange. It's available for the Neo and Net5 token. So as opposed to the other one we looked at, it actually already is currently working. So you can actually click on the exchange here and go to their exchange platform. And as you can see, it looks very similar to any other decentralized exchange. So then we have Loopring. So Loopring also has an unknown market cap at the moment. Total supply, 139 million LRN. So that's very low. Market cap is unknown, coming in at $13.99 on CoinMarketCap, so very close to the bottom. As you can see, it debuted in May, and it's been on a downhill pretty much ever since. So Loopring is also a decentralized exchange, so the protocol for decentralized token exchange. So you can think of it similar to, I guess, ZRX. It's a protocol for swapping tokens and coins. So obviously, we've seen what ZRX has meant to the ERC-20 platform. It's in the top 30. 35-ish tokens right now. Of course, I personally believe it will eventually be in the top five. So this could be a gem that you could possibly invest in. And if it can do for Ethereum and token swapping what ZRX has done for ERC-20s, then maybe it could also have a meteoric rise. So, okay, final thoughts on Net5 tokens. A lot of these projects I don't know enough about to really push them forward, but I do know Ontology is going to be really big. It's going to continue to climb. So I left Ontology out of my top 10 in 2019, what I believe will be up there, but I should have given an honorable mention because I could see Ontology moving into the top 10. Of course, Neo also, I predict, will be very high in that list, possibly in the top 5 very soon in the next year at least. So I love that. The key. I love the key. I love what they're doing with identity verification. I think that is a big problem right now in the world. People pretending to be other people, pretending to be other ages, trolls, whatever. So I really like what they're doing. As I mentioned, gas is, I just don't see the point of really investing in it because I do believe it is tethered to Neo. Of course, I guess people could almost make that same argument with anything in Bitcoin. But it's just, I was invested in it pretty heavily at one point. But, you know, what I saw is those numbers would move so close to each other, I would rather have diversified my portfolio. So I also really like Deep Brain Chain. So I mentioned before that I think borrowing computer power is going to become a bigger and bigger thing in the future as we're asking these machines to do these really complicated processes and complex things. But our computers aren't progressing at the same rate that other technologies seem to be progressing. So for that reason, if you're going to do something in the AI space, you're going to need more computer power. I couldn't run CGI on my MacBook here, and it's a good MacBook. So I think that borrowing that computer power is going to be really big. And I love anything that's in that space. Golem, iExec is another one. There are many more. I know I'm leaving one out that I've already looked at. I can't remember exactly. But Holo. Holo is another one that is doing something similar. So I think that that space is really big. There's a lot of opportunity here. So out of all of the smaller ones that we looked at, so I would say it's probably between AlphaCat and Zeepin. I think AlphaCat is one that is an investing platform and smart algorithms. We're starting to see more people trade cryptocurrency based on algorithms and data instead of just feeling and gut, which I'm sure a lot of the big investors have been doing already. Zeepin, I really like anything that's in the content branding arena. Also, Loopring, like I said, if it could be what ZRX is to Ethereum, if it could be that to Neo, then you could be looking at a monster on your hands. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching this video. I hope now you understand what all the NEP5 tokens are. Maybe you got a favorite in there. Let me know. Drop a comment below and let me know what your favorite NEP5 token is. So until next time, that was your Simplified Coin Review.